guys, how's it going? Shiftmaster here. Today we'll be starting a new let's build on this lot here in slash warp Sandy Acres. It's the city where I'm in. This house will be styled after the Craftsman style of architecture, which is actually similar to a Victorian, except it's usually not as formal. It's not as ornate. The lines on the houses are usually a lot simpler. The roof lines are usually a lot shallower, so you're not going to have, you're usually not going to have an attic. Sometimes you do. You don't usually have formal rooms, such as like a formal living room, a formal foyer, formal dining room. Sometimes you do, but sometimes you don't, just since the rooms are a lot less formal. And that's pretty much it. Cleaner lines, not as formal, and you'll still get some of the more ornate details when you get into the exterior, but we'll get into that later. So let's go ahead and start getting into the layout of this thing. This is actually going to be based off a house that I designed years ago on a different kind of design software. So what I do remember is that there was, at the front of the house, there is going to be the master bedroom, which was here, and then the front door, and then a dining room over here. And then at the back of the house was the living room and dining area, and then the kitchen. So let's see that. And also, Craftsman style houses tend to not have, they tend to not have, well, like I said, formal living areas. So the living areas are usually a lot more open. So that'll be interesting to see in sort of more historic houses. But yeah, so let's go ahead and, actually don't want that big, get to work here. So let's see if I can remember this correctly. I remember, so this is gonna be the bathtub, and this front area is gonna be like the master bedroom, or master bathroom rather. So I remember coming back, and then the front door was here. So, something like that. See, the door will probably be somewhere like that. Maybe. Maybe like that. And then, yeah. Then I remember the dining room having a bay window. Then, nah, it's kind of small. Here we go. So, that's pretty much going to be the front of it. Let's go ahead back. So, I had a master bathroom. It's probably going to be about this big. And then the actual bedroom part. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah. Be about this big. With the living room is going to come off like here. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, I guess. And then that actually wraps the kind of the footprint of the house off. Let's see. Oh, there's something going on. There we go. It's more right. There we go. We'll see how that looks, because I'm really not sure how I feel about that yet, but we'll see. Oh, I know something missing. There. Now it's going to look more like a bay window. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. And that pretty much wraps it up as far as the footprint of this thing goes. So as far as room layout, like I said, this is going to be master bedroom. That's going to be the master bathroom. This is going to be the living room, dining area, kitchen, dining room, and this is going to be the foyer area. So with that being said, start laying this out. I remember, actually, let's go ahead and do something like that. Okay, so that's the dining room. That's the kitchen, living area. The kitchen is bigger than the living area, though. I don't know if I like that. That's weird. Alright, oh, let's see. What if we make this smaller? Like I said, it's been years since I've even fiddled around with this floor layout. So it's going to take me a bit of catching up. Let's push this back. But the master bathroom doesn't need to be that big. Alright, so we got... It's a pretty nice size for a bedroom. We got the kitchen, dining area, living. Okay. Next is to actually start putting some vertical on this. I remember this part was stone. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let me think. Okay, so we're gonna have... There's gonna be two different colors going on here. There's, of course, gonna be a white trim. We're gonna have sandstone for the upper part and brown wool for the lower part with a white trim and window trim. Let's see how the standard dark log will work. So we're gonna do that. 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Alright. And then I usually want heavier or the darker materials at the bottom and the lighter materials at the top. So in this case, I'm going to have the brown wool at the bottom and the sandstone at the top. 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to have 5 high ceilings in this building. So 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5. Okay. And have that. Something like this. For the bay window, which actually isn't going to go all the way up. Instead, it's just going to be for the bottom portion of the house. And the top portion will just have a regular window. So, I'm actually making the trim. Oop, probably went too far there. I'm actually making the trim layer now for the, to separate the upper material from the lower material, because it will be a different material, and you don't want the two materials clashing together, because that'll just look kind of bad. 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I remember this master bit, or the master bathroom part, actually shot out farther than the upper portion of the house, so. Tidbit right there. Alright. So we got the basic kind of frame, I guess you can call it, for the house. Then for this bay window, I'm gonna do something like that. A little bit of that, some of that. Alright, and then for the upper part. We'll get to that in a minute when we actually start doing the upper layout. But so this is the bottom layout. I actually forgot. Well, do I need that? Yeah, gotta do. Then the bathtub will probably be too big. But there we go so far. Let's go ahead and lay out a little bit of floor so I can start building the steps. 0, 5, 1. There we go. Just a little bit of world edit for speed purposes. So, this foyer is actually big enough that I can actually have a 2-wide staircase. So that's kind of cool. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Since I'm using 5 high ceilings, I'm going to need a 6 high staircase to actually get up to the next floor. Like here. Alright. Let's go ahead and line this, because I'm going to use... Actually, I want to use a stone roof instead of a wood roof. Either one would work in this case. Stone or wood roof will work. Just depends on your personal preference. But I'm going to go ahead and use the stone roof here. So, actually, one thing on craftsman houses, the easement on the roof will actually pop out more. So usually, like, standard easement is like a foot, which is actually this part here that kind of shoots off over the actual facade of the house. But here the easement usually pops out. It could pop out 2 or 3 feet, maybe even 4 sometimes. So in this case, instead of popping it out 1 block, we're going to actually pop it out 2 when we get to that point. So, well, in this case, yeah. Here we go. So, since we'll have that, actually, like I said before, craftsman equals shallower roofs, so the roof is going to be something like this. And of course, easements pop are going to pop out 2 blocks here. Like so. Alright. It's going to look something like that. Then I'll get the rest of it on. Oh, I have it. I already have that block in my inventory. Alright, and oops. Okay. So that's that part of the roof. We're gonna end up doing that to the entire part up here. So let's go ahead and lay out second floor fairly quickly, and then I'll probably end part one with that. I might actually put in a little bit of the front facade as well once I get the layout. This floor up here. So in my drawings, this is actually a, what I want to say, 5-bedroom, 3-bathroom house, 3.5-bathroom house actually. But I'm actually missing a couple things, like the attached garage. Since this lot is like across a river, I actually don't have enough room for an attached garage, which would rally stretch out to about here, and I don't really want to have to chop through all this, chop these trees down, and cross this river with a driveway just fucking have a garage. I didn't feel like it was worth it, so I was like, forget it. I don't have a garage. I replace 051. Alright. And then oh, I remember this being a 2-story foyer too, which actually isn't standard in historical buildings. Well, sometimes it is, usually bigger ones, but not in houses. But don't quote me on that, because I have actually seen 2-story foyers in like 120-year-old houses, so it does exist. Anyway, so we have a 2-story foyer, and then the room layout, as I remember, this was a big bedroom with something like this going on. This actually had an attached bathroom, but in order to do that, I have to have something like this, which will make that bedroom really small, and I don't want to do that. So I have 2 bathrooms for sure, because there's going to be a bathroom here with 2 more or 3 more bedrooms up here. So let's go ahead and lay those out. So we got, oh, I might actually be able, no, that'll be small. Let's see, how do I remember this? Oh wait, what if I put, that'll be awkward. Ooh, this is tougher than I remember. Okay, alright, so we got this. So all that will be 1 bedroom maybe, or I can actually do that. Oh, I can actually have the attached bathroom still. So, have this bedroom with the attached bathroom, another bedroom, another bathroom. 2, 3, 4. There, that'll be a bathroom. And the door here. I remember trying to remember where everything was here. Alright. And then, wait, okay, there. So we got 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bedrooms, 3 bathrooms. Probably not going to fit that half in there, but oh well. So we got a living room, a small dining area, kitchen, dining room, master bedroom, master bathroom here. And let's go ahead and add a bit of the facade. Oh, wait, I forgot. Second floor is going to have this different kind of material up here. So, there, there. Then I said I was going to try that kind of trim. Something like that, and then I remember this window actually ended up being pretty small in the original drawing, so it will make sense for it to be small here as well. Well, not small, but like skinny and long, which is what it is. So that's cool, it'll work out. But let me add this oh, I got that. Add this quick piece of roof here. Like so. Wait, maybe? It's 3. Alright. And then up here. Something's not adding up. Oh wait, this part. There we go. There we go. Alright. And then for this part, I remember I just put 2 double pane windows here. Should actually be pretty cool. Of course I created sandstone there. Okay. So that's the front facade so far. We got the layouts done for both floors. Part 2, I'll finish more of the exterior, do some roofing, etc. And that'll probably wrap up part 2. But keep a lookout for that. Like, comment, subscribe, all that jazz. And I'll see you guys in part 2.